Hello guys, so today I've got another video for you, and actually some of you were asking me about which kind of software I use for developing mobile games, and as well some of you were asking which kind of computer setup I've got. So today I'm gonna share with you these things. So first things first, so this video again sponsored by these cool guys from Exola, and today I'm gonna tell you about another feature that they have.
You guys probably heard that starting September 21, Apple allows developers to tell about sales channel of their app subscriptions and game items and currencies outside of the store directly to players.
And Exola actually has a solution for that. So Exola Top Up is a simple and easy way for users to add virtual currency to an account from anywhere at any time. You can create a web store to sell your in-app purchases. All you need to do is download your catalog on the website powered by Exola, and your players will just need to log in using their player IDs and purchase them. This way you can save on the platform fee, and also you can give players options how to pay. And also you can make exclusive offers such as bundles. And utilizing this product will enhance discoverability for your game and elevate your brand while simultaneously opening up new revenue streams. And you can use the data that is generated to improve your player experience. And to start using Exola Top Up in your game, register a publisher account and activate functionality of Top Up. And I'll leave the link how to do it in the description.
I wanted to tell you which kind of tools I'm using for the game development, which kind of software. So first of all, I'm using Unity. I used to use Unity Pro version, but at some point, because I was very annoyed with the Unity logo when you launch your game, if you know what I'm talking about, because when you launch your game, you've got this Unity logo showing up in the very, very beginning. And I was kind of annoyed with that, and I thought, like, I want to get rid of it. And I used to pay $50 per month just to get rid of that logo, you know. And at some point, I understood that it's not worth it, actually, to pay that much just to remove the logo. So now I don't pay anything for the Unity. I'm using Unity free version. And so I use Photoshop for the graphics for many, many things. I use it a lot. And for the music and sounds, I use Adobe Audition just to adjust some files. I don't actually create music. I've got some freelancers also helping me out with that. But sometimes I download just to get some rough idea about what kind of sounds I want to have in my game. And or maybe I need some additional sounds. So what I do, I normally go to a very, very cool website. So it's called freesound.com, and you can download free samples of different sounds just by typing different keywords in the search field, and it's gonna get you a lot of very, very cool sounds. So I use that one, but then I just adjust them using Adobe Audition. And what else I'm using? I also use TexturePacker, if you heard about this tool. The TexturePacker basically allows you to pack your sprite sheets in a very efficient way. I don't use it a lot, but because I still use Photoshop and I place most of the sprites manually. But if you have a lot of different sprites, I would advise you to use TexturePacker. I think you have to pay around $20 just once. Yeah, I think you pay yearly around $20-something or even less, and you get that. It's very, very cool tool as well. And what else? So also I wanted to tell you about my computer setup. And I use my laptop. I use my laptop for my main job as well. And so basically what I've got there, CPU i7-7700HQ with 2.8 gigahertz. And I've got also installed RAM, which is 24 gigabytes. And also I've got for the video, the graphic card, I've got GeForce GTX 1070. It's not that new, that this laptop, but it actually allows me to do what I do and actually allows me to create games. And it's more than enough for this kind of purpose. And I bought it 3 years ago for, I think, or around $2,000. So it was pretty good. And this is a pretty good laptop. I actually really enjoy Republic of Games laptops because they're basically like workstations. It's a gaming laptop. But it's actually super powerful. The graphics is great. The sound card is great, the memory, the CPU, everything just perfect for the things that I do. Alright guys, so hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're new to this channel, just smash the subscribe button And don't forget about the like button as well. And guys, in my next video, I'm gonna tell you about very, very cool and useful tool for people who are looking to get voice narration for their games. And it's just crazy. It's just amazing. I just found out about it recently. And I'm just gonna explain you all this in my next videos. Bye-bye.